Revision 85. It was during the 19th century, China did not allow evangelists into its territory. Even people of the East India Company were actually preventing those who would come for that purpose. Robert Morrison had a burden for China. He took a keen interest in leading the Chinese to Christ. He started a mission through East India Company as he was a businessman and also a missionary. Within 18 months, he compiled a dictionary in Chinese language. Because of this, the East India Company appreciated him and appointed him as a translator. Though he had many trials in his family life, he focused his attention in translating the Bible into Chinese language. In the year 1815, he translated and published the New Testament into Chinese language. Because of this, the East India Company dismissed him. Even then, with his intellectual capacity, he rejoined the company. Even though many troubles and trials came in his way, he published the entire Bible in the Chinese language to the people of China. As he spoke among the Chinese women about the importance of knowing Christ, many women joined the Bible classes held in Morrison's house. They became God's servants. Morrison, who worked very hard for 25 years in China, translated the Bible, the imperishable treasure. This act has to be praised as long as the world remains. God, even if I have to lose my job, I will stand strong in my ministry. Dear friends, I hope this video challenged you to live for Christ and to do something for Him. Share this video with your friends and like this video, leave your comments in comment section and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click the bell icon. All glory to God. Have a good day.